Hi there everybody, Jen here. I'm singing a 60th themed party, so I've decided to make myself a monochrome dress to wear to it. And since I'm going to make it myself, I'm going to video it all for you to show you my process. So I have been sewing since I was 17, ran a business when the children were very young and I was in my 30s. So always had a passion for dressmaking, got all the paraphernalia, I'm afraid, all the pattern drafting stuff, all of the sewing machines, etc., the cover stitcher, that kind of thing. And I discovered this company called Shobin, which actually sell all the back pattern blocks, so it takes a lot of the trouble out of it for you, you know, all the headache of trying to get a fitted item, because you buy the blocks which come in these big huge rolls, big sheets of paper with pattern sizes from size 6, I think, or size 4, UK size 4, right up to, sorry, no, it says there, UK size 10, right up to UK size 22. And you can get these in a basic block, which has got the darts in, or I've also got the sportswear one, which is the stretch fabrics, and I've also got the gents or the less fitted block as well over there. So what I do, because I make myself a lot of clothes, I've used some card and traced out the stretch, what I call the body conscious block, which is just a fitted dress with a vest style sleeve there. So what I'm going to do is trace around this first of all, and then use the paper that I've got down here to modify the pattern and make it the style I want. So here's a quick sketch of the dress. I don't know if you can see that. So it's blocked material, so I've got a glittery panel here, a black one there, and opposites and tail. So there's four panels in the length of the dress, the same at the back, and then there's like a yoke. Here are the fabrics I'm going to use. So this is a gorgeous fabric from White House Fabrics. I think they're called White House or White Lodge Fabrics. Quite pricey, so I only usually buy them by the meter and try my best to get the most out of them. So that's going to make up one panel, and then I've got almost like a ribbed style fabric, which is firm, you know, it's got a bit of thickness to it. Sorry, it's a little bit dark on this, a little bit of thickness to it, but still got the stretch that I need. Okay, so let's get started. One of the things I do quite often is try my best to hold on to outfits that I really like the style of. I kept this dress because I particularly like the neckline on it, and I'm going to use that as something as a template to trace around. That's it with regards to the pattern for this dress. I've already decided that these markings, the one that runs across my breast line, the one that runs across my waistline, and so on, are going to be the sizes of the monochrome pattern. What I need to do next is match that same information that I've put on this block onto the back. Now this stuff is a wonderful thing. I don't understand why more people don't use it. It's like tracing, so it's got like a carbony waxy texture to one side, and you literally use a tracing wheel, and now all I do is lay the fabric behind this pattern, and I trace around the boxes, obviously numbering all the boxes consecutively, remembering to put seam allowance on each panel, and the same on the back. So I'll show you how I get on. I just want you to note that remember, there's no requirement to fold the fabric in two, because not one panel is going to be the same as the next. So you're literally tracing one piece in silver, one's going to be in black. here are all my sequin panels cut out, ready to go. I think if I'd have thought about it, I'd have started with the black, but there's something about the sequins. I just need to get out of the way, hoover away and clean up. I'm going to use these pattern pieces now because they have all the seam allowances already included in them to cut around the black. So one thing to remember is that all of the panels I'm cutting out now need to be a mirror image of my sequined fabric, so I'm going to place those face down. Okay, all of the pattern pieces are cut out now, and I'm just going to cut the neckline sections. Okay, it's time to start putting it all together. So I've pinned all the centre fronts and the centre backs, and then I can start putting the pieces together. Also neatened the armholes with some bias binding, hand stitched those. I didn't want any stitching to show on the front. I've also neatened the head opening on the neckline, which is there, same again with bias binding, and I've just pinned the yoke, which is a neckline, onto the dress. I've tried it on. It's a little bit long, so I'm thinking about taking a little bit off this last panel. But other than that, it fits nicely, it looks great, and I'm really pleased with it. So I'm just going to quickly sew the neckline and come back and show you all. So everything's been sewn on the sewing machine now, so I'm going to stop filming for now. I'm going to sit on the sofa and do all the hand stitching, all the knitting of the edges, the hem, that kind of thing. And I'll have the big reveal tomorrow. So that's it for tonight.